right now.
I know.
We already did this done.
It's so cute.
Hi, Carolyn. Yeah.
Flowers, please.
Are gorgeous,
we
Carolyn.
Love the flowers.
Oh, love.
It looks gorgeous in there.
Okay.
Okay. Can we catch it to an end? Yeah, I know.
But first you must risk going into the unknown. And then when that becomes the known, there is something new to not know that you then go into. So that gets to the second requirement for marriage, which is courage, to take the risk to be able to go into the unknown. Because to truly love one another, to truly be intimate, means to be able to be vulnerable with one another, to be able to break open.
I take you, Erica.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
And before our loved ones.
And before our loved ones.
I promise you.
I promise you.
To respect.
To respect.
Honor and care for you.
Honor and care for you.
This ring is a symbol of my love.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
Introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Matthew Hutchinson.
Thank you. Thanks. Thank you.
folks. And he said, oh, this is brilliant. At the end, we'll put a little piece of grass with a flag, a pole with a flag on it, just to give you hope.
Gentlemen, for the first time, let's hear it for the new Matthew and Erica Hutchinson!
Is very, very
at least on our side of the family, we've never seen him act this way. And Erica brings something to the table that I didn't think anybody could ever do. You know, she's kind, she's gentle, she's beautiful, but she also keeps you in check, which is awesome. So without further ado, you know, everybody, if we can raise our glasses, toast the bride and groom here. Matt and Erica, I wish you nothing but a long life, love, and a lot of happiness. Love you, man.
Cheers.
Love you guys.
Once again, our best man, Rob Gardasco.
What happened to you?